students, and welcome back in our biology session. So today in this biology session, we are going to start a new lesson from 5th standard textbook, that is lesson number 22, Growth and Personality Development. Okay, Growth and Personality Development. So this lesson you will found in the 5th standard state board, and the lesson number is lesson number 22. So in this lesson, we are going to see about how the person is grow and the personality gets developed. How the persons grow, how their personality develops, and which are the different factors which helps them to enhance their personality or to build up the personality of a person. And this lesson is the last lesson from the schedule number 6. So let's start the lesson. First, we will discuss about the skill and efficiency. Okay, first we will discuss about the very important point, that is what skills and efficiency. So as we started to grow, we are having our food. So with the help of the eating the food, we are growing physically. Okay, we eat and we grow. So this is not about only the human being. All the living things eats and grow physically. So if you observe yourself, okay, if you observe yourself in the mirror, then whenever you was in the first standard or whenever you was in the nursery, that time your height was too short, but now slowly now you are in the 6th standard. So now if you will observe your height, then you are much taller than the nursery. Okay, so it means what? Up till the age of the 18, our body is growing, or there is a growth of the body is happens in the human being. Okay, so here we can say that the growth is happen up till the age of the 18. And if you observe your classmates, okay, if you observe your classmates, some are having the height which is more than you, and some are having the height which are shorter than you. Same with the weight also. Some are having the more weight and some are having the less weight than you. Okay, so all these things, or they are growing since they are small. Okay, and your growth will happen up till the age of 18. So as a human being, we are learning so many skills or so many things in our daily life, or throughout our life we are learning the different things. Here we will call them as a skills. Okay, so let's discuss about the skill and efficiency. So if we talk about the small baby, so whenever the baby is of the 6 to 7 months, the baby cannot do all the movements properly. When if that baby wants something, then how will they reply or how will they communicate with the parents? What the baby will do? That baby will start to cry. The baby can beat their hands and their legs. Okay, so in this way they are responding to their movement. With the help of that, what we can say? That baby wants something. Why the baby is doing like that? Because whenever we are smaller, so during the some period of the age, there are not the proper movements, or there is not the coordination of the movement. Okay, but as the baby is growing, after the certain period of the time, after the certain age, the baby started to control its movement, and there is a coordination between the movements. So the baby slowly start to show the something that baby want. If he want a teddy bear, then they are pointing towards the teddy bear. If the baby wants something to eat, then they are showing the food that are something I want to eat. Okay, so in this way, slowly the babies are learning the different skills. And when there is a proper control in the movement and there is a proper coordination in the movement, then the baby can do the different things very easily. So in this way, once they learn how to control the movements and how to coordination happens in the and how to coordinate the different movements, then the baby can do the different tasks very easily. We can say that picking something, or picking the plate, picking the ball, throwing the ball, then hitting on the plates, or to showing them some food materials, like the different tasks the baby started to do. Next one, when the baby at the age of the 1 year, then they started to walk slowly, okay? And after the 1.5 year, the baby started to speak one words, okay? So when the baby speak first word, or when the baby walk the first step, then we are feeling so happy. We Yeah, praise the baby. Very good, very good. Come on, now you can do it. Like that, we are praising the baby and we are so happy. And in this way, what happened? The baby started to do that same thing again and again. And after a certain period of the time, what happened? That first step, whenever the baby is taking the first step, they cannot control their body very easily. But by doing that same thing again and again, the baby started to walk very easily. Okay? So the walking is the skill. But that baby started to practice that skill again and again. And after a certain period of the time, what happened? The baby can walk very easily. So after practicing, what happened? The baby gets efficiency in the walking. Okay? So whenever we are practicing the same skill again and again, then we are getting the efficiency in that certain skill or in that skill. Same with the talking also, that baby is slowly, slowly speaking the one word, Then again and again they are speaking, we are telling them to say this word, say baba, say ai, like that we are telling them to speak. And by learning all this, they started to get the skill of the speaking, and slowly, slowly they speak very fluently. That is, we can say that what? Efficiency. We can say about yourself also, if you feel that certain things are very hard, okay, and if you practice that things, then you will also get the efficiency in that particular task. Every day we are learning something. For example, we can see here, we are talking about your baby. So once the baby started to perform the different tasks, he started to show the different movements. The baby pick up the ball, the baby throw the ball, it hits the ball with the legs. In this way, the babies are showing the different types of the tasks with the great efficiency by doing the practice. So once the baby started to walk, once the baby started to walk properly, slowly, slowly it started to run. Okay, that is also what, first it started to walk properly, it means what, skill get developed, and slowly, slowly that skill gets converted into the efficiency, and with that great efficiency, the baby can now run also very fastly. So if we talk about the human being, then throughout our birth to our death, we are learning something. And whenever we are learning something, we are adopting the different skills. And it is very important to adopt the different skills. And these different skills we are learning from our parents, grandparents, from our adult person, and from our teachers also. Okay? So these different skills makes our life very easier. If we learn the more and more skills, then we will be independent. Okay? If the skills are more, then we will be the less depends on other. But it is not very easy to learn all the skills, because see, all the people don't know how to stitch the clothes, and that's why we have to go to the tailor. Everyone don't know how to prepare the food. Okay, so in this way, everyone is not very much efficient in the cooking of the food. So there are the certain skills that we cannot get efficiency in that, but we should try that skills also, because what, if the skills are more, then we will be less depends on other. So now we can see that the baby started to walk, run, and with that these things the baby started to do the different activities, and these different activities is now the part of its daily routine. They can walk, they can run, they can hop. Okay, they can throw the ball, they can catch the ball, they can hit the ball. So all these are the different activities which they can do very efficiently in their daily life. Also, we can go one step ahead. The babies can now hold the spoon, they can eat the food very easily. Also, they can pick up the glass of water, they can drink the water. Also, we can say that washing one's face. So all these are the daily activities. Now it will be the part of their daily routine. Okay. So see, from the birth up till then now, you have also learned about the different skills. And if you do the practice in that different skill, then you will be also the efficient in that different skills. Now we will discuss about the next point, that is what? Development. Okay. So development is what, as we grow, our weight, our height is growing, okay? And our height and weight is growing, and with the help of that, our physical strength is also growing. So that is only what? Development. only the physical development is not there. With the help of our age increase, our mental development is also getting focused. Okay, our mental development is also happens. Okay, whenever we are growing with the, whenever we are growing, that time whatever our physical growth is happen, and whenever the physical growth is happen, that time we are learning the different skills also. So everyone, every human being is doing the progress, and that is nothing but what development. That is only called as what development. Okay, so now we will talk about the animals. Animals can learn the different skills from their mother. Okay, so how to protect them from the enemies, how to find out their food, how to protect themselves from the sun, water, rain or cold. So in this way, all these are the different skills which were learned by the animals from their mother. But as we do the comparison between the animals and the human beings, then as compared to the animals, the human beings learns the more skill in their life. So as a human being, throughout our life, we are learning the different skills. Okay, so this is about what development. So now let's discuss about the next point, that is what heredity. What is meant by heredity? So in our before some points we have discussed that the human growth is happens up till the age of the 18. So at the age of the 18, the persons become an adult person. Okay, the persons get converted into an adult person. Or the age of the 18, that person is called as what? Adult person. So our height, weight is increasing up till the age of the 18. So while we are growing, okay, while we are growing, certain, or when we born, that time what happens, certain characters comes from our parents. Okay, so we can say that somehow we can look like our parents or our grandparents. Some of our habits are similar with our family members or the siblings of our parents. Okay, why this happens? Because during the whenever we born, that time what happens, certain characters get transferred from our parents to the offspring. Okay, some of the characters get comes from our parents to the offspring, and that is only called as what? Heredity. Okay, so being born with certain features or traits in common with the members of our family is heredity. Okay, so certain characters, certain body features, our physical growth, our physical attire or our physical look, our build, our facial expression or our face somehow looks like our parents, our grandparents or the siblings of our parents. Okay, so in this way what we can say, that some characters are getting passed from the parents to the offspring, and that is the reason we are looking quite similar with our parents, and that is only called as what? Heredity. Okay, so being born with certain feature, okay, we born with the certain features or traits in common. In common means what? These are the common with us and with our parents, in common with the members of our family is a heredity. Okay, next one, these are the inherited traits. Okay, inherited traits means what? These are the certain characters that we get from our parents from our birth. Okay, and that the characters are going on one generation to another generation. Okay, means from our grandparents it comes to our parents, from our parents it comes to ourself. Okay, and again it will go and pass to the next generations also. So that is only we can say that what, these are the inherited traits. So these are the inherited traits means the going on process. Okay, going on process which transfer from one generation to another generation. But say here we are taking that some characters transfer from the parents to offspring, but it is not in our hand that which characters will comes in the offspring, or it is not in the human hands from which characters from the parents is get transferred to the offspring. Okay, so it is the naturally it will get transferred from parents to the offspring, and that is only called as what? Heredity. Next one, with the help of this heredity, with some skills also get comes to ourselves. Some skills are also, we can say that hereditary skills, we can say that. If the very rare case, it is not, we cannot say the confirmly it is the skills will happen. For example, if the
singer is there, it doesn't mean that singer's child will also be singer. It will be doctor, it will be engineer, it will be cricketer. But somehow we can say that if the singer is there, then the certain good voice characters will get transferred to the offspring, and it is the possibility that that baby also will be the singer, okay? But it doesn't in the control of anyone's which skill will get transferred from the parents to the offspring, okay? So this is about what heredity. Now the next point we will discuss about the good diet, okay? So it is very important that one should take the good diet. So in a growing stage, the children require the special diet, and if the children doesn't get that special diet, then there are the certain diseases that we have already seen in our previous sessions, that the malnutrition are there, or the marasmus is there, kwashiorkor is there, that child gets suffer from these different types of the diseases. So in that particular age period, the children require the special food. We can say that growing stage requires the more amount of the protein. So once that stage will get finished, and after that stage it will provide the protein rich food, then it is not useful, okay? Then because of the lack of the protein, their heights will get also if their heights will not grow properly, or their weight will also not get increased properly, okay? So during that certain period when it requires the protein rich food, in that period only if the child will get the proper food, then only their development will happen very properly, then only their physical development happens properly or nicely. Next one, we can say that other factors that supports growth and development. So good diet is there for the proper development, but with the help of the good diet, the one should take the proper rest, one should do the proper exercise also, and very important, there should be the good habits in that person. There should be not any type of the addiction in the person. If we are having all these things, then obviously our growth and our developments will be good. We should develop our body, and we should learn the different skills to make ourselves more independent. Whether it is boy or whether it is girl, everyone should has the right to develop itself and to get enriched in their life, to get a good quality life. Okay, and the next one and the last one, we will discuss that each one has a unique personality. Okay, it is very important. Each one is having unique personality. No one is as similar with other. Okay, each one is having the certain different character among yourself. We can say that if the 32 students are there in the class, then each and every child is a very good in her or his self, because each and everyone is having the different skill. If someone drawing is good, then we can say that the someone is good in the sports. If someone is good in the Marathi, then other one is good in the science. So in this way, we can say that the different skills are there. Someone can draw very nicely, someone can sing very nicely, someone can dance very nicely. So in this way, we can say that each one and everyone is having the unique personality. Each and everyone is having the different skill. We are not looking same to each other. Our face is different, our personality is different. So every person is different in all others, okay? So our personality can get developed, and our physical and the mental development is not same at all. Everyone is having different physical development, and everyone is having different mental developments too. So how to maintain our personality, how to develop our personality? So our personality develops through our interest and our habits. If our habits are bad, then obviously our personality will be not good. So our personality get developed from our habits and from our practices. So if you do the more and more practice, then you will be good in certain skill, and then you can develop your personality. Our personality develops what we do, or what we are having interest and which type of the efforts we are doing. So what we have to do and what we don't have to do, with the help of that we can develop our personality. So while developing our skill, we are learning about what we have to do, what we, which is good, which things are good for us and which things are bad for us. With the thinking about all this, we can develop the personality. So one can develop their personality if our thoughts are good. If we are thinking positively, then will be our personality becomes good. So we can say that our personality can be said excellent if we will think a good thought in our mind. Okay. So this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the different points regarding our growth and the personality developments. So this is all about today. Today we will stop here. We will meet in the next video, and this is the time to tell you goodbye. And for today, thank you.